So welcome to today's session titled More Hands on Deck, Graduate Nursing Immersive Experiences. My name is Dr. Amanda Kazee, and I am from the University of Central Oklahoma, and I'm acting as today's moderator. So today's session focuses on a structured, faculty-designed immersive field experience in which graduate nurse education students were embedded in an RN-to-BSN online course. After the experience, the graduate students felt better prepared as nurse educators, and the undergraduate students received timely, individualized feedback with more hands on deck in the class online classroom. Today's presenter is April Nelson, the Nursing Program Director at Northeastern State University. If you have any questions during today's session, feel free to use the chat window, and I will keep an eye on that for April to interrupt if necessary, or we can save questions till the end of today's session as needed. And with that being said, I will go ahead and turn it over to you, April.
Thank you, Amanda. I appreciate that. And yeah, I'm a nursing program director, been a nurse educator for a long time, and also still practice on the front line. I was full-time on the front line in the ICU when COVID hit. So I stayed there and took a break from education for a while to help out on the front line where nurses were really needed. And during that experience, nurses have always been innovative, both in education and in practice, but even more so now. And that's part of how this idea came about. So like many programs at NSU, nursing was trying to do more with less. So my solution and what became one of my favorite teaching strategies and teaching experiences ever was creating graduate nurse education immersive experiences, embedding them in the undergraduate nursing program. So this started with a course, Nurse 5453, it's assessment, evaluation, and nursing education. So I completely redesigned it for this experiential learning activity where the graduate students served as graders in an undergraduate course. So as the faculty for both the MSN and these BSN sister courses, I facilitated the graduate level competencies for MSN students. And then the MSN students ended up providing a human capital to positively impact the student learning experience in the undergraduate course. So my objective for this presentation is to share what worked and what didn't work with that experience, to see if we can identify opportunities for inter-program learner collaboration and engagement, because we're all very familiar with like interprofessional education, which is really important, but sometimes we forget that we can help each other out within our own programs. And then provide some ideas to help you prepare for planning and implementation of an inter-program immersive learning experience. So some of the things we were facing is the competencies that are used for MSN academic programs. These are core expectations. And in April of 2021, the American Association of the College of Nurses came out with their updated essentials in these, they call them level two competencies that were to be used by programs to prepare nurses for advanced practice, including a specialty like nursing education. And we need to combine those with specialty competencies and certification standards for nurse educators defined by like the National League of Nursing. So we were seeking to advance disciplinary expertise for future nurse educators. We wanted to provide rich and varied opportunities, both with direct and indirect care experiences. We wanted to provide the didactic learning and promote innovative thinking within our didactic courses, because the way the program was set up and still is set up, the students have a course designated for them for their practicum experiences. And a lot of times experiential learning is limited to those practicum type courses. So we really embrace the challenge to help provide more sufficient and appropriate experiences to help students develop these graduate level competencies and the specialty standards. And we wanted to be able to do that in a diverse setting and meet the course objectives. But how are we going to do this? You know, right now, NSU Nursing has two full-time faculty and we have 300 students, 111 MSN students, and over about 250 plus undergraduate students. So how we just look at each other and how do we do more? And I know everyone faces this challenge of trying to do more with less, but we took it as a golden opportunity to be a smart, proactive educator and see how we can do more with less. So our proposed solution was that the students who were in my assessment evaluation and nursing class would have a field experience in an undergraduate NSU nursing course. We were also experiencing growth within our undergraduate program with our online classes having students 60, sometimes 80 in a class, and again, being limited by resources, faculty resources. So in this structured faculty designed experience, those MSN students were embedded. They had faculty oversight by both the MSN course instructor and the BSN course instructor. We used the Blackboard learning management system. And so the students were assigned a grader role, which is a designated role within Blackboard. And what was nice about that is it limited their ability to edit or make changes to the course, but they did have full access to the grade book and rubrics and those types of things in order to facilitate grading and to be a part of the team. And so now we had more hands on deck in order to help meet the needs of our program. So as we were developing and trying to think of what this looked like, we did a little bit of research into immersive and experiential learning. And that is not new to nursing or to education by any means. But one of the things I was finding that in the more current research that immersive was a lot of times aligned with a virtual reality type of experience, so VR type simulation. We still imagined immersive as being immersed in the experience. So you're surrounded by it, you can't get away from it. So being in the classroom and being immersed in that educator role, in that BSN course, and their role, how they interacted with students in that instructor type way and as an educator was the immersive experience that we were looking for. And the immersive experience aligned with the AACN competencies. It was different than they normally did as students in their didactic courses. We did still have a blend of visuals and technology in that the students were using those resources. And most importantly, they were learning by doing. So to help facilitate it, we adopted Kolb's experiential learning cycle. And according to Kolb, the transformation of experience into being usable knowledge takes place in the four stages of a concrete experience, whereby the learners immerse themselves in the new experience, by choice or not, we put them in there. But in this case, they were grading papers and providing feedback in the education environment. It's also important for a reflective observation where the learners can reflect on those experiences. And in the abstract conceptualization phase, the learners form ideas and they integrate those observations into action. And in that final active experimentation stage, the learners become actively involved in the experience and they test those previously introduced concepts. So as a program director, one of the big things that I've learned is the difference between change and transition. So for me, how I view that is change could be, I want to move a lamp from this side of the room to the other side of the room. And that could be the change I want, but in order for me to make that transition, I need to think about other things. So is there an outlet on that wall? Will the cord reach the outlet? Will this lamp on this table be safe from my dog when my dog gets the zoomies and starts running around? So we wanted to make a change, but we needed to think about all the transition that is involved with this and who all it will impact. So for the MSN faculty, they would coordinate, supervise, and evaluate the MSN students participating in the field experience. And the MSN faculty also assist the BSN faculty in directly supervising them within that undergraduate course that the students are embedded in. The MSN faculty were responsible for creating an IT ticket so that the university could embed the students in Blackboard into that grader role and give them access. The BSN faculty provides the direct supervision of the MSN students reviewing all work before releasing it to the students. So what we did was we would hide it in the grade book, and that allowed the MSN students just full access to leaving grades and to leaving feedback. And then all of the MSN student work would be reviewed and edited as needed before releasing that to the students. And then the MSN faculty obviously has to have permission from the BSN faculty in order to collaborate in this way. The first time that I did this, I had a different faculty as the BSN faculty, and we worked really well together. It was a great experience for both of us. The next time I assigned myself to both courses, I will say that was easier because it was just oversight of both. And it was just one less person to be involved in the coordination when there's all of these students that are involved. However, it did work both ways, but it was definitely easier to be in both. And I know personally, I enjoy teaching both graduate and undergraduate courses. I know sometimes faculty really lean one way or to the other, but I do think as an educator, even a graduate educator, that being involved in teaching undergraduate courses makes me a better graduate educator also for graduate, especially graduate nurse education students. So considering some things for the students, for the MSN students, as these field experience serve the purpose of meeting the course objectives and they're a progressive reinforcement of the competencies, I wanted to be sure that the workload fit within the standard course expectations. So they weren't needing to spend an extra 20 hours beyond 20 hours of homework that they're expected to do. So the course was completely redesigned to accommodate that. The MSN students ended up being assigned one discussion board for one group for 1 week. So they had about 10 to 20 students within that week of discussion boards that they would do. And then they were also assigned 1 to 2 scholarly written papers that would be part of their field experience. And during the field experience, they would actively utilize the evaluation techniques that they were learning in class and apply that in relation to the student performances for these undergraduate students. We wanted to protect the BSN students too. So all the grades, assessments, feedback, anything that came from the MSN student was reviewed by the course faculty to ensure fair and appropriate evaluation. And because the students do have that right to privacy, the MSN students are expected to uphold FERPA principles and expectations. And that's actually a competency and program expectation for all the students within that nurse education specialty track. And so they've all been trained and prepped for that and understand what that means. So for implementation, here's how it looked like for us. This is an example of the MSN side of Blackboard and the assignment and the field experience and what it looked like for them. So using Blackboard and an issue, I call it Blackboard OG. We use Blackboard Original. And so there's actually a lot of tools besides discussion boards that are available for us. So for this one, I used the Wiki tool. And what I like about that is that it allows students to go in and edit and creates a really great sign-up feature. So this is what you're looking at is a screenshot of the MSN assignment in their Blackboard course. So the students were provided an opportunity to select a week that would work for them, and they would know that that week would probably have more work than maybe their typical week. So they can plan around their schedule and not sign up for a week when their sister's getting married or some other big family event is going to be taking place. And then because there are multiple discussion groups within the undergraduate course, there would also be multiple MSN students within the same week. So within Blackboard, within using this Wiki tool, I was able to set up some additional pages that had additional background information for what the undergraduate student expectations were, because in their graded role, they did have some limited access in the undergraduate course and couldn't necessarily see all of the objectives or all of the other details that go into evaluation that they would need to have. And then also there was a page created for inter-rater reliability. So the expectation is that students within, for example, here in Module 8, that they would grade their assignments and then collaborate with each other and look at each other's works to see and compare and make sure they're on the same page. Because I really think that is important within all education, that when you have multiple sections of a course, that there's some consistency between how the students are being evaluated and assessed. So, and then their due dates that they were given as MSN students were shortened to allow time for the undergraduate faculty to review the work, make edits as needed, and still get it back to the BSN students in a timely manner. And because our goal is to get the feedback to them within a week, that meant the MSN students had a few days, gave the BSN faculty a few days, and then getting the feedback to the BSN students. So hopefully they can apply it and make improvements to their next week's work. This screenshot is an example from the BSN course where the MSN course where the MSN students were assigned scholarly papers. And for this, it's a sign up. However, I assigned the students, the BSN students to the MSN students. The MSN students can go directly to the grade book and access the work that the BSN student had turned in. And they had the dates for this, the dates when they would be able to start using and start evaluating, then also when they were expected to have their feedback and grades returned. For all of these, they were using Blackboard rubrics, leaving feedback. An additional expectation for the MSN students in this scholarly paper assignment was to use the MS Word track changes feature. And I know that they were familiar with that as students, having received feedback from me in that way through MS Word, but it's also new to them and how to use it. So I would hold weekly Zoom sessions for the MSN students that they could attend live. They weren't mandatory to attend live, and I always recorded them and posted them in Blackboard. But a lot of students would come live so they can ask their questions live, or they would send in their questions beforehand and I would address them. So in these live Zoom sessions, I would review what their assignments were, I would go into that undergraduate course, show them how to navigate the grade book, how to use the rubrics, how to leave feedback, just all kinds of tools, a little hands-on demonstration. And then I also did a walkthrough of how to use the MS Word track changes. And then I also posted links to additional resources like Blackboard Help and MS Word resources on how to do that as well. But that was really helpful because I didn't want technology to get in the way of their assessment and leaving feedback. However, I did also want it to be part of the experience is using those rubrics. And then there's additional tutorials and expectations were provided to the students as well. And both of these had an expectation for inter-rater reliability and collaboration and knowing what was expected for the BSN students. So here's an example from the BSN side. This is the discussion board's assignment, and you're looking at the MSN students' feedback in the discussion board rubric, and then their general feedback they would provide to the learner. So one expectation is that the students should provide, leave their name, so they and I know who was leaving the feedback. And then I would go through and make changes as necessary. If I did make a change, I would always communicate that to the MSN student and explain why. Sometimes it was maybe they didn't notice something. For example, our grade book has an expectation criteria for use of APA. So maybe they gave them 100% for the APA, but it wasn't quite 100%. It could be the other way. And sometimes I would raise the score. And that would be a discussion with me and the MSN student that sometimes it just comes from experience and expectation for what is expected of this BSN student at this level compared to maybe a BSN student at a different level or an MSN student. But a lot of times that would just create great discussion and a learning opportunity.
And April, I'm sorry to interrupt here, but we've got about 4 minutes left in our session. So I just want to let you know.
Great, thank you. So we have the scholarly paper rubric, and this is their use of the rubric. What I see in this example is they would start to mimic how I would give them feedback, which I think is great because we can learn from others good or bad. So they would use the point system and provide feedback. And I would always go into the BSN feedback and provide additional instructions that and leave a comment from me so the BSN student could be assured that their grade was supervised and approved by their faculty and feel less like it was unfair or something because an MSN student was grading them. So reflection's important. And after each activity, the MSN students completed a field report and their questions focused on key elements of assessment evaluation. Are we meeting the objectives? Can they improve the discussion prompts? That was actually really helpful. And some of that was implemented. Looking at the rubric to determine if it was clear and appropriate and asking how much time they spent. And if they encountered concerns with performance or academic integrity, and there was some, and we worked through that together in those issues. And then for inter-rater reliability, looking at each other's works and looking at how they compared. So some of the interesting responses, this first one here, what I'm seeing is maybe a little bit role confusion. Confusion is probably not the right word, but that balance between they're a student, so they won't know what it means to be a student, but then also making that transition to that educator role where they felt like they were maybe grading harshly, but then also seeing accountability and inter-rater reliability. For the time, several students put 3 hours, but some would say that was less than they expected. Others thought 3 hours was a lot more than they expected. I could see the difference in time. Those that spent more time certainly left more feedback and detailed feedback, but not always. But 3 hours seemed to be the magic number. This one about didn't feel good to dock their grade. One, that's really hitting on the affective domain that I was really hoping to achieve with this assignment. And this was a place where I drove home a message that's part of my teaching philosophy is that we don't take away points, that students earn them based on the rubric. And in this final one, I really thought that this also really kind of hit that them transitioning to that educator role and really being able to see what it's like to be the educator and that we don't like when students don't do well. And she's picking up here on the fact that when they're missing parts of the rubric, you know, your hands are tied as an educator. So I also wanted to look at the effectiveness and evaluate it for quality. And so the students completed these just Likert scale questions. And as you can see, for the two semesters that we did this, the vast overwhelming majority agreed, and really most of them strongly agreed that they were felt better prepared to use assessment instruments to evaluate outcomes and provide thoughtful feedback. So this is really just a small scale. It was an evidence-based activity as an opportunity for students to integrate their theoretical and practical applications and evidence-based standards to assessment evaluation, hopefully in preparation to their future role as a nurse educator. And as the responsible faculty for the sister courses, I facilitated graduate level competencies for the MSN students, and then also had the added benefit of my undergraduate students really getting some more personalized individual attention as well. And given the overwhelmingly positive response indicated by the student feedback, we created more immersive experiences with the graduate and undergraduate collaboration. And this multimodal educational intervention was so successful, I certainly encourage other faculty to consider it as well. So just as a final wrap up for graduate nursing immersive experiences, I found that teaching the assessment and evaluation using experiential learning model provided that valuable opportunity for growth and development. The experiences are central to Kolb's theory, and he viewed them as a process by which something must be changed or transformed. So we focused on the student learning outcomes and their career pathway, and that also something should be generated from the experience. So in this case, it was the grades and the evaluation and the feedback was the product, and that memorization and recollection of ideas that doesn't necessarily equal learning. So we wanted them to have a chance for reflection. And this whole active learning experience had faculty guidance and oversight to be cheering them on and help and helping them along the way. And that it took into account the multitude of gray areas for nurse educators, time, feedback, content, APA, all of those things. So here's the references I used. And sorry, I didn't leave a lot of time for questions, but if you guys have any, I'd be happy to answer them.
Thank you, April. I really appreciate you sharing your information, your expertise with everyone. If I haven't seen any questions come through in the chat, but if there are any, please let us know. You can always reach out to April. Her email address is on the screen right now, or you can always check out the presenter information in the Zoom lobby events area to get that information later on if you'd like to do so. That being said, I'd like to thank you all so much for joining our session. I believe the next sessions begin at 1 o'clock. So we've got a short break here to grab lunch or whatever you need to do. And then we'll see you guys later this afternoon. So thank you all so much for joining us today.